Here we have a photo of the first and second parts of the secret in Lucia's own handwriting, just so you can see what it looks like. She writes in Portuguese. And now we will go to the second part of the secret. My time is running out. It is a prophecy about the end of the war. Remember, when Our Lady appears, it's in the midst of World War I. And she says the war is going to end. But if people do not cease offending God, a worse war will break out during the reign of Pius the 11th. The Pope at the time was Benedict the 15th. Heaven already knows who the next Pope is going to be and knows his name, Pius the 11th, whom you see there on the right side of the screen. When you see a knight illumined by an unknown light, know that this is the great sign given to you by God that he is about to punish the world for its crimes by means of war, famine, and persecutions against the Church and the Holy Father. So peace is conditional on our not offending God. And that happened on the night of January 25 to 26, 1938, 2 months before the start of the Second World War. And Our Lady says this, to prevent this, so the war is preventable, I shall come to ask, and she asks for two things. One, the consecration of Russia to my Immaculate Heart. And two, the communion of reparation on the first Saturdays, which I will explain later. If my requests are heeded, Russia will be converted and there will be peace. If not, she will spread her errors throughout the world. She will cause wars and persecutions against the Church. The good will be martyred. The Holy Father will have much to suffer. Various nations will be annihilated. Communism is the devil's main tool of destroying the Church and the world. And to end the prophecy, our Blessed Mother said this, in the end, my Immaculate Heart will triumph. The Holy Father will consecrate Russia to me, and she will be converted, and a period of peace will be granted to the world. So Fatima is a message of great hope. We await this period of peace, but we have to do our part to bring about that peace. Sister Lucia said, we did not heed Our Lady's appeal, and we see that her prophecies have been fulfilled. Russia has invaded the world with her errors. And if we have not yet seen the complete fulfillment of the final part of this prophecy, we are going toward it with great strides. What is the final part of the prophecy? Nations will be annihilated, but in the end, my Immaculate Heart will triumph. And it's preventable, huh? The annihilation of nations is completely preventable. But we have to listen to our mother. The third secret, and here you can see again her handwriting and how she starts every paper with the initials JMJ, Jesus, Mary, Joseph. Do not use their names, huh? Very casually. Now, for the first time, Our Lady does not speak to the children. What happens is a series of images unfold before their eyes. And it looks something like this. First, they see Saint Michael the Archangel holding a flaming sword, and he is about to touch the earth and scorch it. And he says three times, penance, penance, penance. And then from Our Lady emanates this beautiful light that prevents Saint Michael from touching the earth, from the fire, from touching the earth. And then the scene switches. And what the children see is a man dressed in white, whom they assumed to be the Holy Father. And Lucia said it was the Holy Father, although they couldn't tell which one. And he is walking amidst a city that is in ruins, with his head bowed down and with his step very slow and halting. And he's suffering a lot. The city is all in ruins. And he goes up this hill. You can see him going there, up the hill that has a large cross on top of the hill made from the cork tree. And all around him are dead bodies, priests, nuns, lay people, people from all walks of life, rank and file. They're dead, and he's walking up, and when he gets to the top, he is shot with bullets and arrows, and he dies. He collapses and he dies. The angel with the flaming sword represents the threat of judgment which looms over the whole world. Today, the prospect that the world might be reduced to ashes by a sea of fire is no longer fantasy, because man himself, with his inventions, has forged that flaming sword. What is he talking about? The nuclear bomb. No? Man himself has, with his weapons, has forged that sword, capable of setting the world on fire. And Ratzinger says that the repetition of penance three times means God will intervene in the world when we do penance. We must turn from sin. We must accept the urgency of the invitation, convert our lives. And Our Lady's special weapon is always the rosary. She's holding it there, no? The rosary. Because we're in a spiritual war. The war is spiritual, and therefore the weapon has to be spiritual. The rosary has the power to defeat all the destruction that can happen. On August 13, the children were kidnapped on the way to the Cova by the Masonic mayor of Urem, Arturo Santos. If you remember, the Freemasons are in power and they want to eliminate religion in the whole country. In fact, the prime minister boasted that in two generations, Catholicism will no longer be around. So he wants them to deny the apparitions and sign a paper saying they made the whole story up. He throws them in jail. You can see the window, the actual window of their jail there. And the children were terrified. They were scared. They were threatened to be thrown into a cauldron of boiling oil. Individually, one by one, they were taken aside and told, your brother or your cousin was already fried in the oil. It's going to be your turn unless you deny. And each of them was willing to go to their deaths in that terrible way rather than lie. And while waiting in jail, Jacinta knelt down, put her rosary on the wall, and she led, together with the children, all the prisoners in the prayer of the rosary. She was suffering so much that Francisco said to her, Jacinta, remember Our Lady said, when we suffer, we can offer our sufferings. Choose your intention. Do you want to console God? Do you want to save sinners from hell? Or do you want to pray for the Holy Father? Because she had a special devotion to the Holy Father. And Jacinta's reply was, I choose all. Right? So very big, generous heart. Finally, on August 15, the feast of Our Lady's Assumption, the children were released and they were driven back to Fatima. They could not be influenced. And instead, Our Lady appears here in Valinhos, and there is a monument that marks the spot where she appeared. And she told Lucia, had they not taken you to Urem, the miracle would have been much greater. The miracle that will happen in October. It would have been far greater. Continue praying the rosary every day. Pray and make sacrifice for sinners. Many souls go to hell because there are none to sacrifice and pray for them. And then September, again, the rosary. Continue to pray the rosary in order to obtain the end of the war. There are now 25,000 to 30,000 people present. The children are having a hard time getting through the crowds. So it's now October 13. We're going to have the famous Sun Miracle of Fatima. There are at least 70,000 people there. In fact, there is a doctor, Dr. Almeida Garrett, who was a science professor at the most prestigious university in Portugal, University of Coimbra. And he was there measuring the crowd by square meter, counting the heads, right? And then multiplying it. And he said there were at least 100,000 people there. The miracle I'm about to describe is the most astounding and exceptional miracle in history, other than the resurrection, because it was predicted 3 months in advance. The specific time, specific place, specific date, with a specific intention, so that all may believe. Huge crowd arrived in a torrential rain, mostly on foot, their clothes, their shoes, muddy, dirty, soaking wet. These are all original pictures taken from cameras during the time of the miracle. There were many illustrious men of the arts and sciences there. Almost all of them were unbelievers. They were there for curiosity. They were there as hostile witnesses. Many of them wanted to disprove the children. The editors of the most anti-religious, anti-Catholic publications were all there. There's the crowd, everybody waiting, anticipating, many of them bare feet, as you can see. And only the children can see Our Lady. She finally reveals herself. I am the Lady of the Rosary. Continue to pray the Rosary every day, so that God may forgive you for your sins and that you may go to heaven. And please pay attention to the next line. If people amend their lives, the war would end this very day. Do not offend the Lord our God anymore, because he is already so much offended. And then she opened her hands. The light came out again. She ascended up into the clouds. And the reflection from her body and her hands reflected on the sun. And the sun was like a silver disc with a sharp edge. And you could stare at the sun. And what happened? The children beheld first the Holy Family. Remember, Saint Joseph was coming. And Joseph with the child Jesus, together they blessed the crowd. And then Our Lord of Sorrows and Our Lady of Sorrows, Our Lord blessing the world. And finally, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, just as Our Lady had told the children. And then Lucia cried out, "Look at the sun." And you can see all the people there looking at the sun. We suddenly heard a cry of anguish from the entire crowd. The sun, while keeping its rapid movement of rotation, freed itself from the sky, and blood red, it plunged towards the earth, threatening to crush us with its fiery mass. It maintained itself a short distance above our heads, and it seemed so near the people. Those were terrifying seconds. This is from Dr. Garrett, Almeida Garrett, the scientist. A miracle of unprecedented proportions points to a message of unprecedented importance. I just want to emphasize that. At no time in the world has there been a miracle like this. When our Lord died on the cross, the sun darkened. In the Old Testament, there were two sun miracles. You know, one, anyway, no time to go into it. But this is unique. This is completely unprecedented, unparalleled, very historical. It confirmed that Our Lady was speaking to the children.